Welcome back. We are counting down the top 50 most jacked fullbacks to ever play in the NFL. Today, we're going through numbers 35 through 31. So let's get right into it. All right, at number 35, we have Joey Iosefa out of Hawaii. He was drafted by the Bucks in 2015, but didn't make the final roster cuts. Later got picked up by the Patriots and appeared in a couple games for them. To my knowledge, this is just what everyone from Hawaii looks like. They're 250, strong as hell, super jacked. You can see the tricep popping out here. This man was an absolute beast, super powerful runner. We got some lifting footage here. 500-pound close-grip bench off a block, spotter's jaw straight to the floor. Then some pin squats here with adding weight. We're at 455, 475. We'll never know if he got it. Box jump, everyone's shocked once again, and then 425, 43, close grip bench, and the spotter just can't believe what he's seeing. He only suited up for two regular season NFL games, but as you're about to see, still managed to make a big highlight.
Tom Brady, favorite, New England Patriots. Gentle Lee.
Number 34 is Kyle Juszczyk, definitely one of the bigger names we've seen on this list so far. Went to Harvard and was drafted by Baltimore in 2013, and he's been with the 49ers since 2017. He's made the last 8 Pro Bowls, and this picture right here is just ridiculous. The sun is hitting him perfectly, and he's looking absolutely jacked. Same with this picture. Lighting is ridiculous, and might make it controversial that we only have him at number 34. He's definitely leaner than most fullbacks, but he's not a typical fullback. He does a lot of different things, and he's very athletic and potentially future Hall of Famer, but I think that is definitely not a lock, but you could make the argument.
We'll be right back.
Number 33 is Tony Fiammetta out of Syracuse. He was drafted by Carolina in 2009, played a couple years there, a couple years with the Bears, and 1 year in Dallas. He was a college All-American in 2008 at fullback, and this man was an absolute specimen. Not only was he jacked and swole, but he was a freak athlete as well. When he did the 225 bench at his combine, he got 30 reps, and he also ran a sub-4.6 40-yard dash, which at 6 foot, nearly 250 pounds, is highly impressive. And can you believe it? He's originally from Hawaii, so it goes to back up my earlier point. And we have some lifting videos. Here he bangs out what I think is 30 or 31 reps with 225. And if you remember episode number 2 with Deion Anderson, there were some clips of DeFranco's gym in New Jersey. It's a private gym for athletes. This is also from DeFranco's. Tony appears to have had some time there back in his playing days. And we have some dumbbell incline with 150 here. He's just toying around with them. And not only that, but he just re-racks them with no difficulty whatsoever. And at number 32, we have Jon Ritchie. This is just an old-school fullback here. Super, super tough. And you can see the blood on the forehead. Apparently, he had some sort of scar that would open up basically every time he played, so he was always bleeding. Definitely looks very cool. And he was drafted by the Raiders in 98, spent 5 years there before going over to Philadelphia for a couple years. And how about that mullet right there? That is a mullet. He was an awesome player, super powerful, big blocks, and also got a good bit of action out of the backfield receiving. Got into sports media after he retired, and he currently hosts a morning talk show in Philadelphia.
You know, if the average individual is wound like a baseball, Ritchie is wound like a ball of yarn. He's just a little looser and different than most people.
Okay, and at 31, we have Dan Kreider, another classic fullback, undrafted out of New Hampshire. He played for the Steelers for 8 years and had 1 year stints in St. Louis and Arizona. 5'11", 250, he was a thick guy, and he was nicknamed the bus driver as he was the lead blocker for the bus, Jerome Bettis, for a good chunk of his career. And if you just take one look at this photo, you already know what position he played. Won the Super Bowl with Pittsburgh in 2005 when they beat the Seahawks, and very well-liked player up there in Pittsburgh. And this is what it's all about right here. You have a peak bulked fullback physique, thick chest, goatee, a neck that protrudes outside of the line of his own head, which is just amazing. I'm not sure if you're familiar with the West Side Barbell crew from back in the day, but you cannot tell me that he doesn't fit right on in with these guys. He wore that neck roll underneath the jersey just to let everyone know that it's going down, and he was just an awesome player.
For rookie free agent Dan Kreider. And Dan Kreider has been a great surprise for the Pittsburgh offense. He's mainly at blocking back, but you see right there, just a little quick trap inside. This guy is explosive, and he is powerful. He is the new bus driver in this offense.